Hey everyone, it's Carissa Wiley at SprinkledWithGlitter.com. Thanks for joining me today. You know, I really just love love. And today it is all about the love. And I absolutely love essential releases from Pink Fresh Studio because the products are so versatile. And the Shaker Hearts won my heart. And I'm going to be combining them with the Folk Garden 2 suite here, product suite. And I'm going to be doing some hot foiling and creating a couple of love-themed cards. Now, I wanted to kind of go this direction because I think a lot of times when we think about hearts, we think about Valentine's Day, but really, love is not seasonal at all. So I wanted to create something that was kind of maybe even a little more wedding themed because I do have a wedding coming up and I thought this would be a great kickstart on some wedding cards for the spring season. So I've gone ahead and heated up my Folk Garden 2 hot foil plate on my foil press, and I've placed my champagne colored foil with the pretty side facing the design of my hot foil plate. Then I've added my hammer mill cardstock and my shim, and I've run that through my Gemini Junior. And you can see that I have a beautiful foiled image. I did cut off a little bit at the bottom, but it's okay. Now I had previously foiled these brush sentiments from Pink Fresh Studio, and I keep them in with my stamps, dies, and stencils so that when I am reaching for a sentiment, I have them right there. And they had not been die cut yet. So I grabbed the coordinating die and positioned that over the foiled sentiments and ran that through my Gemini Junior to die cut these sentiments. Now I'm also taking this panel that I foiled with the Folk Garden 2 hot foil plate, and you could do this with the stamp as well. And I am taking my largest shaker heart and I'm just kind of turning it and twisting it until I find kind of an area of this design that I really like. Then I'm going to take the small shaker heart and I'm going to do the same. I'm holding them in place with a little bit of repositionable tape. And then I'm going to run those through my Gemini Junior to die cut those out. Now, the thing I love about the shaker hearts and the shaker stars from Pink Fresh Studio is they not only leave a stitched edge on the actual die cut piece, but there is also a stitched border around the negative portion. So if you are using these to create, say, a shaker card or something, you have that very cool stitched detail around your window as well. Now, through the magic of television, I have gone ahead and used the coordinating stencils to add some color to a second panel of the Folk Garden 2 hot foil elements here. I used Peach Fuzz, Coral Reef, Blue Jay, and Stargazer to create that beautiful combo. And then I am using the Folk Edge rectangles. These are also brand new in the latest Essentials release to die cut this pink cardstock. Now I am going to do a little stacking of my die cuts here. So I've cut out a couple additional hearts using those shaker hearts. And I'm just using some liquid glue to adhere those together. And the thing I wanted to tell you about the Folk Edge rectangles is that they also have solid rectangle shapes that I'm going to use in the next card. So you get 6 dies in this set and they're all very versatile. So you can either have plain rectangles or rectangles with that really beautiful folk edge as well. Now I'm doing a lot of die cut stacking today, and you don't have to do that. You could use some foam adhesive instead, but I just was in the mood to do some die cut stacking, and so I'm doing that. I've added 2 layers of plain white die cuts behind this foiled love sentiment, and then I am adding a layer of vellum, just kind of offset just a little bit to create a shadow, and I finished that stack off by adding a 3rd plain white die cut behind. So this has plenty of dimension, and that vellum is going to kind of float off of the card front as well. Now I'm using just a single element from that Folk Garden 2 set there that I die cut out, and I'm placing that on the left side of the heart. I am adding my stacked up foiled sentiment there on the right side of the heart, and then I'm going to stack this all together. This is a very simple card, but it is so beautiful and perfect for a wedding or bridal shower. I love the florals and the foils all mixed together with those beautiful shapes and all of the details that those add. So let's jump into a second card. I have actually used the radiating background die from Pink Fresh Studio to die cut some more of that pink cardstock. And to reinforce this, I'm just adding some tape runner adhesive along the back and stacking that onto a piece of heavyweight white cardstock. I'm just pressing that down. Then I am going to take the small shaker heart that I die cut earlier from that Folk Garden 2 foiled panel, and I'm going to do a little ink blending. I've added a little bit of peach fuzz all over the surface of the heart. And then from one side, I'm blending in a little coral reef. And let me tell you, when you blend these two colors together, it is absolute magic. I love it. Now, I've die cut another large pink shaker heart from that pink cardstock, and I decided it needed a little texture. And so I'm using the Folk Garden 2 hot foil plate again, but this time, no heat, no foil. I'm just going to place that die cut onto the plate face down, run it through my die cut machine, and it's going to give me a debossed pattern on this heart. So that's another way that you can use your hot foil plates, is just to create a impressed pattern on your cardstock. Now I'm starting to adhere everything together, and I probably shouldn't have done this quite yet because I decided to trim this down with one of the plain rectangles from the Folk Edge rectangle die sets. So I kind of smashed down my hearts and my hot foiled elements there just a little bit, but I was able to kind of zhuzh them up and give them a little life again. And then once again, I stacked up my foiled sentiment and added that onto the bottom of that hot foiled small shaker heart. And that little heat embossed sentiment that I added along the bottom, I heat embossed that on vellum. And that sentiment that says, sending you so much love, is from the Charming Floral Border stamp set. And there you have it, two love theme cards. The second one, my thought was love you. So the little heart makes the love and then the you. There you have it, a couple of love themed cards featuring some brand new essential products from the Pink Fresh line. As I mentioned before, I really love the essential dies because they are so versatile and you will find yourself reaching for them throughout the year. They really are just an evergreen product, and those little details really add a nice finishing touch to your project. Now, as always, I will have links to the featured supplies used in this video in the description at YouTube. So if you're looking for something in particular, you can check there. As always, I'm so thankful that you stopped by to hang out with me today. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and this project. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications here on this YouTube channel so you don't miss any of the paper crafting and card making video tutorials shared here. Thanks again for watching, and until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day.